You're listening to The Real. With Rachel D. on Atlanta's inspirational talk radio, Love 860. Everybody, and welcome to The Real with Rachel D. Happy Friday. We're glad that you're here to join us at 6 p.m. at Love 860. Like always, thank you so much. We're here with, of course, my fabulous co-host, Miss BJ.
Hello.
And our special guest for the show, Judge Stephen Knights.
In the building.
He's running for Clayton County Superior Court Judge. Guys, remember to go out there and vote. So we're going to get right into the celebrity hot news, and then we're going to talk more about you, Judge Stephen Knights.
All right.
All right, so I do want to start off by saying we actually sometimes pre-record the show, so by the time our show aired last week, the news about Prince passing, we did not get that news, so we definitely want to go ahead and address that, because that was a very tragic moment, because we are huge fans here at the show.
Yes.
You okay?
We are, yes. I was upset. But yeah, it was so sudden. I think that's what got everyone.
Absolutely, because he was just down here, like the week prior, mm-hmm. Performing at the Fox Theater.
Yes.
Did you go to that?
I did not, but I did see the tickets were available. My wife, Keisha, she wanted to go to that show, but we're so busy, mm-hmm. couldn't make it. And she said, once again, I can't go to another show. We were supposed to go to Michael Jackson's last show, couldn't make that, and now Prince. So the next time there's an artist that we want to see, we're just going.
Yeah.
We're just going to go.
Just go.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's a lot of speculation circulating around his death. You know, since then, he has had an autopsy, and they, of course, are trying to find out the cause of death, and he's been cremated. And right now they're working on his, you know, will, because they say he's worth over $600 million, and he did not have a will.
No will, no wife, no kids.
Yes. So they say that the money will probably go to the siblings and be split equally.
Right.
And, of course, like I said, they're still trying to figure out the cause of death. He did have an emergency plan while he was touring. And so there was speculations through TMZ that it was drug-related, that they had some type of stuff in his system.
Right.
And the big thing is, regardless if it was drug-related or not, the one thing that I really, really, really wish would have changed was that the doctors wanted to keep him in the hospital.
Yes.
But his people insisted he needed his own private room, and since there was not one to accommodate him, they left.
Yeah.
And, you know, I really wish that was a different decision. Cause
yeah, they could have kicked somebody out. I mean, it was Prince. Roll him in the hallway.
Absolutely. So, you know, there's more. This story isn't going to go away. This reminded me when Michael Jackson passed. Yeah. It was everywhere, and it was everywhere for a long time. And it was very, very hurtful.
Yeah.
And I actually posted online because there was a lot of people like, well, you guys don't know Prince, so how are you so upset? And it's like, certain artists have been in our lives forever.
For a while.
And it just feels like a family member that just passed away. Suddenly at that. And I remember I woke up that morning to find out that one of my favorite wrestlers passed away first.
Oh, yeah, China.
Yes, China.
Yeah, China.
That was a horrible day, Jesus. And
yeah, I used to love to rock with her back in my WWF days.
You had WWF days?
Yes, when I used to watch stuff and throw people on the floor. You know how you wrestle.
Let me tell you, if my mom supported my dreams and careers, I would be a diva today. Mm-hmm. I promise you. But yeah, former wrestler China, she died. They're still trying to figure out her cause of death, but they did say that she was probably dead for a couple days before she was found.
Which is so sad. I know she was going through some abuse issues as far as substance abuse, in which her manager was really trying to get her some help, but it just didn't come quick enough.
Yeah. So rest in peace to both of those, both legends. You know, yeah, like I said, that day was ridiculously crazy and hard.
Yeah.
And we didn't get a chance to talk about it on the show, so we definitely wanted to address it. And because of Prince, all our music is Prince themed, which mm-hmm. I'm super excited about. All right, so we're going to move on to some better news.
Yay.
So Beyonce had released, what did she release?
She released a visual album on this past weekend via an HBO premiere only.
Okay.
So it was definitely an hour of my life that I will never forget.
An hour times eight, right?
So, yeah, because I watched it several times. And let me say, it is very artistic. It is very visual.
Okay.
So, I mean, it was really good. I liked a lot of her music. And, of course, with this, she dropped some major shade and gave some major tea, because with this video, everyone is now saying that there was some infidelity in the relationship between her and Jay-Z. So
everybody's been speculating that, but the big thing is that she, I think one of the quotes in her song was like, what? Something about Becky with
the good hair. Yes.
And so a part, you know what, and I don't feel sorry for this chick, even though we share the same name, Rachel Roy. Mm-hmm. That's her name, right?
Damon Dash's ex-wife.
Not to be mistaken for Rachel Ray, which everybody has. Mm-hmm. After the song came out, the song's called Sorry, she posted a picture of her and her friend on Instagram. She said, good hair, don't care, but we will take good lighting for selfies, self-truths, always. And so, of course, everybody speculated that she must have been the Becky with the good hair.
Well, that and also, if you remember a few years ago when Jay-Z and Solange got the box in the elevator, right before that, Rachel Roy used to be really good friends with Solange. So her and Solange actually got into it that night. She was seen by witnesses arguing on the floor. Then later after that, she was playing Captain Kangaroo in the elevator with Jay-Z. So a lot of people put two and two together and they figured maybe it was Rachel is Becky with the good hair. But I saw her roots, so it can't be her.
But you know what, though? Because of what she posted, Beyonce's fans, the Beehives, have went to a straight attack mode.
Oh, yeah.
And you know what? Honestly, she deserved it. Let me tell you why. Regardless of if she's actually the Becky with the good hair, you know what you were posting.
Oh, yeah.
You started all that. Nobody was even thinking about you, and you posted that.
You posted that. Then nobody even knew who she was.
Exactly.
So until this Becky with the good hair. But now people are kind of going after Rita Ora, too. Because right after Lemonade, Rita Ora Snapchatted herself in a bra with lemons on and a necklace that said Jay on it. But we've seen her roots too, so she can't be Becky either. So.
Well, let me tell you though, their marketing people are geniuses.
Oh yeah.
I bet you Jay-Z and Beyonce have probably the best marriage than anybody.
Oh yeah.
Have all of us speculating and having people like this. Like Rachel Roy, I mean, she did it for publicity and she got the publicity she needed.
Right.
Sometimes when they say all press is good press, sometimes not really.
No, because
she got death threats.
Against her and her family.
Did you see the Wikipedia page that the fans had edited?
No. They were going hard for Bey.
They said that she died on April 25th under a lemonade stand.
Wow. They really, really were going. Did you know? Okay, so in the video, let me just point out, in this one song where Beyonce was walking down the street, Hold On is the name of the song. She had a bat in which she was smashing car windows with, and the name of the bat was Hot Sauce. So I saw somebody put a meme with Hillary Clinton holding a bat, said, I too carry hot sauce in my bag. Jesus. So it was hilarious.
So what do you think about that, Judge Stephen? I know you've been busy. So
yeah,
you
know, I saw the I saw the preview and I didn't get a chance to actually watch it. I saw the minute and a half, I guess the ad for it.
Mm-hmm.
And I just saw Beyonce through the ring and I said, what's this? So I actually read a quick article on it and it turned out, I don't want to spoil it for anyone, but it turned out that I guess everything's okay.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the video, and it's really all about making the amends and moving on.
Exactly.
But I do want to see it. Maybe I catch it this weekend.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
I might have a bootleg.
And
please do. I need that, too. Okay, so moving on. And BJ, you must never, ever pull one of these.
Uh-oh.
You are not allowed.
Michael Strahan?
Yes. Don't you dare pull Michael Strahan on me. Never. Okay, so that was another big thing that hit the media last week, or earlier this week, I guess. Michael Strahan is accepting a full-time gig at Good Morning America.
Yes.
And leaving live with Kelly and Michael.
Ooh, but they said Kelly didn't take it good at all.
She didn't, and it's because she didn't know until everybody
else knew.
He announced
it, yeah.
Which I do feel like that's rude and disrespectful. I mean, that's your co-host. That's somebody who's brought you on and brought you along. And you should definitely communicate with her. Give her time to process it.
Right, and then don't just spring it on her like that. So she actually had to take some days off from the show to recuperate.
Yeah.
Like, she was hurt, wow. You know.
But apparently, their relationship wasn't all it was cracked up to be.
Oh, no.
Because he wasn't going to leave until September initially. But now he said, 2 weeks, I'm gone.
Oh, yeah. Something must have went down. So.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, maybe he drank too much of the lemonade.
That's what I'm thinking. And you know what's so sad?
What?
Is I don't even watch that show.
I don't either.
I stopped watching it after Regis. And I mean, I'll be honest. After Regis left, I kind of stopped watching it. So.
Yeah,
but I really thought he brought some flavor and pizzazz to the show. And now that he's leaving, I think they feel bad. Like, well, now who's are we going to lose part of the audience? But I did. Bow Wow's trying to go for it.
No, please.
Did you hear that?
I didn't.
No,
Bow Wow's trying to be the new guy.
Bow Wow needs, no.
Do we still remember the award show?
Does he have a real name now? Is he?
It's Shad Moss.
Okay, there you go.
Oh, I'm going to say Masu Fafa or something. I couldn't remember. But you remember how bad he did live during the award ceremony?
Yes.
Goodness gracious.
And I think with Michael Strahan, like, I mean, good for him. He did bring a lot to the show. I mean, he's been all over the place because he does host Isn't he still working at...
Yeah, he still does the ESPN show.
ESPN, mm-hmm. Good Morning America. He's been all over the place. You're not mad at... I'm not mad at him for capitalizing, but there has to be a reason that you'll go from a show of two to a show of five.
Right, and I know exactly what it is. And it's money.
Money.
Yeah.
And also, you know, a hostile work environment.
Oh, yeah.
Because those hostile work environments, BJ, will make you want to quit or leave or find something better,
they
right?
They sure will. And ain't no lemonade about that, so...
All right, guys, so you're listening to The Real with Rachel D. We actually have more show coming up for you, some more celebrity topics, some crazy stories we found on social media, and, of course, we're going to get to know our guest, Judge Stephen Knights, better. So make sure you keep it here. Remember, we're doing Prince tributes. So coming up, we have Purple Rain. All right, guys, welcome back to The Real with Rachel D. That was Kiss from Prince. Woo-hoo. Guys, it's all Prince all the time here on The Real with Rachel D. And we're being joined by, of course, Miss BJ. And our special guest, he's running for the Clayton County Superior Court Judge, Stephen Knights.
Stephen Knights, your most qualified candidate for Clayton County Superior Court Judge is here. Thank you, Rachel. Thank you, Miss BJ.
Yay.
And I'm back.
Yes.
Second time. It seems like so long.
It
too
has
long.
Been. We have a new home and everything.
There it is.
Been here.
Nice. Thank you for the welcome once again. I'm excited to be back. And we are less than 72 hours from voting.
Yay.
Early voting starts May 2nd, Monday, 7 a.m. Make sure you take yourself and 10 friends to the poll. Let's have a poll party.
Yay.
Let's head on out and vote.
Absolutely. I like that.
So can you explain to everybody, since there's different types of judges, like what exactly is a Superior Court judge?
Yeah, so Superior Court covers several areas of law. The most important is felonies. So mm-hmm. serious felonies, punishable by, of course, 1 year or more, or up to life in mm-hmm. prison and the death penalty. So about 75% to 80% of Superior Court are felonies. Mm-hmm. Then you have family law, mm-hmm. which is, of course, divorce, child custody, child support, visitation, adoption, those areas. And then the miscellaneous type of areas, personal injury and those type of contractual disputes. So that's mm-hmm. Superior Court. One area that distinguishes myself from anyone else that's running for Superior Court in my race is that I'm the only candidate that has done civil asset forfeiture. Hmm. Do you all know what that is?
Not at all.
No.
Yeah. You all don't know, and neither do most lawyers, and certainly not the other candidates in my race. So I was a drug prosecutor for 3 years. And mm-hmm. so if someone does something illegal, drugs, forgery, some counterfeit business, whatever it is, they buy homes, cars, whatever they buy, mm-hmm. if they get arrested for that and they now have to show how they made that money, they have to have a civil asset forfeiture trial.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that trial can happen very shortly after the arrest. And so basically it is the assets, the money, the house, the car versus the person.
Yeah.
Then that person has to show what they used to get that money. So let's say, for example, they have a $25,000 fur coat, mm-hmm. a $500,000 house, and et cetera. They have to show, well, they made $1 million last year. How do they do that? W-2 and the tax returns, et cetera. Mm-hmm. They have to show they won the lottery. They have to show it's an inheritance. Mm-hmm. They have to show someone bought it for them. So absent a valid showing of how they made the money to buy these things, then it's seized if they can't show it. And that's done in Superior Court as well.
You know why that is so relevant?
Why?
Atlanta Housewives, Apollo. Remember?
Yes.
They could not prove how he made that money legally, yes. which is why they seized. Remember how they wanted to get in Candy's garage to seize all of that equipment? And that's exactly what you're talking about.
And that's Superior Court, right? So, see, there you go. And so, you know, that's an area that's done, and it's in conjunction with major felonies as well, and that's in Superior Court.
Yeah.
And so that's just one of the many reasons why I'm the most qualified candidate, educating not only the public, but the other candidates
mm-hmm.
on the law.
See, that is so cool.
That is very much so.
And it's called civil
asset
forfeiture.
Yeah, Superior Court. There's several areas of law that are covered there, but the main area is criminal,
mm-hmm.
75% to 80%. And I was actually in Superior Court in Clayton County as a district attorney. And so having a caseload of about 150 cases a month times two, because it was myself and a trial partner,
mm-hmm.
you can imagine the volume. So in any given month, there's only about 3 days scheduled for civil cases. The other days of the month, criminal. So you could be in trial, you could be in motions, et cetera. And so Superior Court is serious because they're felonies. Think about someone's life, liberty, freedom, mm-hmm. proper representation, and God forbid it's a death penalty case where someone will be sentenced to death or life in prison. So this is not something to play around with. I'm exactly. passionate about what I do, mm-hmm. and I've seen it from every angle. And, you know, police officer, solicitor general, district attorney, magistrate court judge, defense attorney, innocence project attorney, this is not the time to play around. Mm-hmm. I don't want Clayton County to be the laughing stock of other counties, mm-hmm. at least not the judicial branch. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You need someone who's qualified. You need someone who knows what's happening. And we certainly know that I'm not doing it for the title. You all remember my dad was a judge. I've been around. Mm-hmm. I was appointed in 2012 as a judge. I'm definitely not doing it for the title. I'm doing it to ensure the safety of Clayton County.
Mm-hmm. We love that.
That is perfect.
So let me ask you, because wow. I've seen you hit the pavement since
yes.
day one.
Yeah.
You cannot drive anywhere, guys, without seeing something, something. Stephen Knights everywhere.
Stephen Knights.
So why do you feel when campaigning, really getting the community involved, is so important for a position like a judge?
Well, just like how we started out speaking, most people don't even know what Superior Court is. Mm-hmm. Now, so the two judges, Matt Simmons and Deborah Benefield, that are retiring, they've been in the position for 24 years.
Wow.
So for 24 years, no one really has went out and educate the public as to what happens in Superior Court. So for, what, a year and almost a half now, I've been out educating the public, letting people know, hey, this is what we're doing. Mm-hmm. For me, it's important because not only does Superior Court affect Clayton County, it affects the state, mm-hmm. and it can affect the country. Mm-hmm. I refer to Ernesto Miranda, a Miranda Rights and Warnings, came out of Arizona. If there's bad decisions on the Superior Court level, it can then go to the state, and then it can go to the Supreme Court, mm-hmm. in the country, and then it could be bad law in the entire United States. So it's wow. that important. It's not just county, it's nation, state, and possibly nationwide.
Yeah, cool. See, I mean, that lets you know you are the most qualified candidate.
The most
just
qualified.
Here, I mean, we have learned
so much.
There it is. And
wow.
we just got started.
Exactly.
And I do think it's so sad because being in the positions BJ and I are asking the questions, that's how we're able to educate ourselves. But for the outside community, who wouldn't think? Because before all this Clayton County running has started and we got to know the people, the candidates, we didn't know Superior Court from Magistrate Court. We didn't know
yes.
the difference. We just thought it was a judge, and they just decide everything.
Yes.
Right.
And so, interestingly, there's, of course, the Municipal Court, where there's the smaller infractions in the city. Mm-hmm. And then Magistrate Court is like the gateway court, mm-hmm. with search warrants, arrest warrants, first appearance, bond hearings on the criminal side. And then, of course, you have the civil side with up to 15,000. And then you have dispossessories, which is landlord and tenant. But when you get to Superior Court and State Court, they're the trial court. Courts, jury trials, bench trials, which is only by the judge. But then beyond that is the Court of Appeals and the Supreme Court, where there's wow. no trials. So, and then there's probate court as well, which deals with probating people's estate, like we talked about Prince and mm-hmm. the estate being situated. So
wow.
different levels of court.
The more you know.
Right.
Yes.
Right. I mean, he has my vote.
Thank you very much. Is that an official
That's
endorsement
an official
from
endorsement.
Miss BJ? Wow.
Well, I don't live in Clayton County, but if I did, I definitely would give
Thank
you my
you very
vote.
Much.
But you definitely got my support.
Thank
so
you.
Can you tell everybody where they can find out more information about you?
Yes, Stephen Knights, your most qualified candidate for Clayton County Superior Court Judge. You can find me on social media, Judge Knights, KNIGHTS, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram are my most active. My website is Knights206.com, Knights2016.com. Early voting starts Monday, less than 72 hours, May 2nd. Through the 20th, we want you to get out and vote like your life depended on it, because it actually does.
Mm-hmm. All right, guys.
Yes.
So you make sure that you keep it here to The Real with Rachel D. We have more great show coming up, and we're going to keep the Prince theme going with When Doves Cry. Keep it. All right, everybody. Welcome back to The Real with Rachel D. That was When Doves Cry. So we're going to talk about one more celebrity topic that actually was just killing the internet over the weekend. So Birdman.
Rachel, Miss BJ.
When you say that name,
are we recording?
I want you to put some respect on it.
Put some what on it?
Say, is we recording?
Are we recording or are we taping?
Okay. Don't even need to explain anything past that. That is pretty much how the interview went.
Yes.
Birdman was a guest on The Breakfast Club with Angela Yee, DJ Envy, and Charlamagne Tha God. And that was a 1 minute and 30 second interview.
Did you see how shook everyone looked? Except for Charlamagne. Charlamagne was like, come on. You done already cussed us out. How come you ain't say nothing to Trick Daddy?
Yeah.
Rick Ross. I ain't got to say nothing to them. I'm saying something to you. I mean, he came in hot. So obviously, I'm thinking there had to be some beef or something before the interview.
Of course. First of all, Charlamagne Tha God talks about everybody.
He does.
So it's kind of like, why even get offended by that?
Yeah.
But, you know, he was going in. And fortunately, The Breakfast Club, because I love to watch their videos on YouTube, was recording it before it started airing.
Yeah.
So you saw he came out the gates cussing and calling him out and all that stuff. He said, put some respect on it.
Put some respect on my name. When you mention my name, put some respect on it.
How you spell that?
R-E-S-P-E-C-K. Respect. But did you see how he had like 40 dudes with him?
Exactly. Everybody wearing sunglasses.
And then it took him forever to leave. I mean, he had to wait in line to leave. He had brought so many dudes with him. You can't leave angry when you got like 19 people in front of you.
His voice was quivering too.
He was cracking.
That's why he had his sunglasses on. He didn't want nobody to see his eyes water.
But I was like, what is Charlamagne? What did they do to you?
Exactly.
But then that part when he was like, the interview over with, is y'all finished or is y'all done? And I'm like, isn't that the same? I mean, he was ready to go. I have never seen someone so ready to go. Why even show up?
I don't know. That backfired. You wanted to come in like you were a thug and intimidate people. That backfired on you so bad.
So bad.
The memes. Like, I seen this one. They had edited or cropped his face into, what's the name who sings Respect?
Oh, Aretha Franklin. I saw them put the Michael Jordan head on him. With, you know, the crying tears. But you know what? It really, really, really did backfire on him. He should have just not showed up.
Yeah. But he did later on apologize, though.
Yeah,
he apologized to DJ Envy.
Do we know what the reason was for him being so upset?
I have no idea.
I mean, Charlamagne accuses him of everything. You know, that picture of him kissing Wayne and him not paying his employees and so.
I thought he was joking on those tattoos on his head.
Yeah.
Because goodness gracious.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. I mean, is you sorry or did you apologize? So, I mean, but I'm glad they squashed it and they're both able to move on. But it made for some hilarious, hilarious humor.
It did. And Angela Yee, you saw she got out the way. She was definitely one of the people when she saw him upset.
Oh, she didn't get in her face like she did with Kate Michelle. Right. She just kind of was like, okay.
Yep, I ain't in it. All right, so let's move on to the craziest stories that we found on social media. And we're glad that we have a judge here.
Yes.
Because we want to get your legal opinion about this.
All right.
Did you guys hear about a man who got arrested for putting soda in a water cup at McDonald's?
No, I haven't heard about this. Where was this?
This was in Springsdale, Arkansas.
Mm-hmm.
Cody Morris, who's 18 years old, was arrested Monday for putting soda inside a water cup at a Springsdale McDonald's and refusing to return the soda. The manager at the McDonald's had called the police on Monday to report a robbery, according to the report. The manager told police three people went through the drive-thru and asked for three large waters. Those three parked, went into the restaurant, dumped the water out, filled it with soda, and the manager told the police. They said that two of the people came back and returned the soda, but the third one wouldn't. So
but not only did he not return it, guys, he fled with the beverage from the police, hit the manager twice with his car, and then tried to block his escape. His vehicle was later found outside a nearby bowling alley where he was apprehended and charged with what? Felony robbery.
Yes. So what happened was it started out really simple. Started out as a misdemeanor or maybe just some type of county ordinance. Pour the soda out, put the water in the water cup. But what took the wrong turn, literally, is when he started a high-speed chase.
Mm-hmm.
That's where the felony comes in, and almost running over two police officers. Mm-hmm. So
it says he hit the manager twice with his car when the manager tried to block his escape.
Oh, so now you have some type of aggravated assault there. I mean, it's extreme. So it started out simple, and it turned into some major felonies.
Wow, all over a watered-down Sprite.
Yeah.
Because I cannot get a strong soda to save my soul from the restaurant. I almost have to, like, just get it straight from the truck. I mean, everything, well, even a fruit punch.
And that's embarrassing. How can you go to jail and they're like, what you in for? Yo, I stole some soda from McDonald's.
From McDonald's.
Yeah, like, seriously, that's embarrassing.
Yeah, hijacking Sprite.
I mean, and then he wasn't even cool with it. You gonna park and come in right in their face and get it? At least just go inside and order and just act like you were confused.
Yeah, or just go to like another McDonald's down the street. Isn't right. there like five in one
yes.
street?
Yes. Or go to the Dollar Tree. Everything a dollar. You can get a soda from there.
Exactly. Jeez. So based off of what you know, like what is this young man possibly looking at?
So if he was in Georgia, then he would have, certainly I counted at least three felonies, right? The aggravated assault on the manager
mm-hmm.
and then the police chase,
mm-hmm.
right? And then, of course, the now it becomes a felony. So he's looking at three major felonies right there.
Wow.
All from
stealing a soda.
Stealing some soda. In a water cup.
That's ridiculous. His mom is probably can't wait to beat him when he get out of jail.
Jesus.
And that will be in Superior Court.
See?
See, that makes me think. We'll get back to more topics. What's the craziest, like, dumbest criminal, I guess, interaction you've had?
There's been a couple. One I could think of was a young man. He was told to turn his music down. It was the summertime. He was told to turn his music down by his neighbors. He didn't do it. And he had his speakers facing away from his house. So it was the entire apartment complex could hear it.
Mm.
The police were eventually called. Two police officers came. And instead of turning the music down like he should have, he got into a scuffle with them, which turned into a full-out brawl.
Wow.
Of course, he got the short end of that and was eventually arrested. So what turned into a simple noise, what started out as a simple noise, ordinance violation, turned into felony obstruction with the police officers simply because he wanted to hear his music louder than he should have. Not
wow.
in his own house, but outside.
Outside.
Dang.
Dude, they have like Bluetooth headphones now.
Exactly.
I mean, goodness gracious.
Okay, back to more crazy stories you found on social media. So apparently a high school basketball store had found out to be 30 years old.
Yes.
Yes.
But that's a super, super, super senior.
Yeah, yeah, the dude is like 6'9".
Exactly.
And I mean, and then he looks like he has a family and a van and a full career. I saw this guy's picture. If you look at him, dude looks like a grandpa. How in the world was he getting by at 17 years old? They should be ashamed of themselves. Have y'all seen this picture?
No, I haven't. No.
A dude straight looks like he owns several stores, has family, maybe even an ex-wife and moved on. This dude looks grown.
He's an African rich.
He's from Sudan.
Yeah.
So, I mean, and then the thing is, his coach, he was living with his coach.
Okay, now they know that man was 30 years old.
Yes. Dude is 6'9". I mean, this guy, he wakes up with a full beard every morning. How can you not... I mean, he was really trying to get him drafted, which is what the coach was trying to do, trying to really ride those coattails and get him into the NBA.
But, I mean, he could have went to college. You know, he could have, I don't know. At 30 years old, you're more likely to pass as a basketball player than a high school.
He the only dude in high school worried about his IRA. Come on.
So, Judge Knights, is there yes. any type of legal issue with this? I mean, he was around a lot of young high schoolers.
Well, if there was some inappropriate activity, then certainly. So he's over. So in Georgia, the age of being an adult is 17. So if he was doing anything inappropriate with any of these high school students, then yes, certainly there could be some legal responsibility and liability for him.
Jesus.
Yeah, y'all look at his picture.
And they said that he's probably going to get deported.
Yes.
For this. Well, that's what happened.
Back to his family.
That was a dumb plan.
It was. I mean, dude, if you're going to pull that off, just go with someone who looks a little younger.
You know who he needs to be friends with? That doctor, that 18-year-old doctor.
Yeah.
All they're doing is swapping places.
They're swapping places.
You have one that's like trying to be a lot older than what he is, and this one trying to be like... That's 12 years younger at max. Jesus.
That is crazy.
Ugh. Okay, so another thing, I don't even know if this is really a big deal, but people like to make something out of nothing, so here we go. On Snapchat, they created a filter for 420, which is supposed to be the national lead, or not national, but unofficial weed smoking day or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So the filter is of Bob Marley.
I saw that.
And so not only does it give you the dreads and the hat and everything, it gives you the brown face. So regardless of what race you are, it makes you a black guy. But, you know, people find that to be extremely racist. They feel the company is being accused of promoting digital blackface.
Wow. And, you know, I thought I was so upset when I saw that because to me, it's not really that bad. It's like a filter. Yeah, I didn't get too offended. The only thing that really offended me over the weekend was Lil' Kim's picture, but I did see.
Let's
but
talk about it.
It did bother, you know, I'm just saying. You talk Kylie Jenner's face? I'm sorry, Lil' Kim's face?
Yes.
First of all, I did not know who she was.
I know. Maybe.
How does Lil' Kim go from a famous African American rapper to a middle aged white lady?
Let me say, I saw this quote, and I don't know if it was her, but it makes sense. She said that she's always had low self-esteem and that the men that she loved always liked European-esque women. And if you think about it, you know, Biggie, Faith Evans, high yellow, nice hair and stuff like that. So that body image issue have just made her tear herself up. She was so pretty.
She was gorgeous. And you know what? Plastic surgeons are never going to tell you the truth. As long as your visa goes through and clears, they're going to give you as much surgery as you want. She could be out here looking like an extra member on Mowgli's The Jungle Book, and they will continue to, you know, to operate on her.
Yeah,
I cannot stand the fact that I can't look at her and see the beautiful person she used to be.
Exactly.
So, and I think it really boils down to a mental issue.
Absolutely. And then with her daughter, you know, she just had a daughter, so I'm pretty sure her daughter will never know the Kim everybody else does.
Her daughter will grow up looking at her arm, looking at her mama, and was I adopted? I mean, because you can't change genetics.
Exactly.
So people love yourselves. I don't care what you look like. Love yourself. Jeez.
Lord. All right, guys, you're listening to The Real with Rachel D. Make sure that you keep it here. We have more great show for you, including Miss BJ's hashtag of the week. So coming up, we have Diamonds and Pearls. All right, guys, welcome back to The Real with Rachel D. That was Diamonds and Pearls by Prince. That's one of my favorite songs. So during the break, we were talking about people with crazy tattoos. It's just a random thing. I think we were talking about Lil' Kim and, and her plastic surgery. And so, guys, would you ever get plastic surgery? Like, unnecessarily. Like, if you got into, like, an accident and you need reconstruction, that's one thing. But just...
I don't know. I mean, I don't. Maybe an extra arm so I can get some more work done. But I don't know. I don't think so.
No, definitely not on purpose.
Yeah. Sorry. All right. So the show is almost wrapped up. But Miss BJ, can you please grace us with your hashtag of the week?
All right, guys. So my hashtag for the week is whenever you are really, really in a hurry and just ready to get the heck up out of somewhere, the hashtag is, are y'all finished or are y'all done? That is hashtag, are y'all finished or are y'all done? And that's just, you know, sometimes you're just so ready to go, you don't really know what you're saying. You just got to go.
I'm sorry. What's the hashtag again?
Are y'all finished or are y'all done? You know how sometimes, like, you know, if you at church and your mom talking, the pastor letting out, you like, man, so are y'all finished? Are y'all done? And, you know, come on, baby, sit down. I mean, it's just, so when you're really ready to get somewhere and you're just ready to go.
Right. And I like that, Miss BJ. If I can, if you're finished or you're done, make sure you get to the polls on May 2nd to vote for Stephen Knight, your most qualified candidate. Once you come out of the booth and you're finished and you're done, take a photo. Tag Stephen Knights.
There we go.
Your most qualified candidate.
Put some respect on it.
Oh, my God. I love you, BJ. Yes, you're not allowed to Michael Strahan. You have to stay
forever. I'm here. I'm going to go vote.
Yes.
And I'm coming right back to the show.
All right. Sounds good. All right. So what are you guys getting into over the weekend?
Well, I'm going to be out in the community, as usual. I have... I'm going to be on the bridge, 75, with our representative Valencia Stovall this weekend. I believe there's a candidate forum at Dixon Grove at 8:45 in the morning. And then I'll just be out meeting folks and getting people excited to go vote on Monday, May 2nd. I'll be at church, a few churches on Sunday, be out and about. And then May 2nd, 7 a.m., Stephen Knight, your most qualified candidate for Superior Court Judge, will be at the polls 7 a.m. May 2nd. Get out and vote. Your vote counts.
Miss BJ.
What am I doing?
Yeah.
I don't know. I just got served with lemons, so I'm going home to make lemonade.
All right, guys. Well, if you don't have anything to do, we actually have a special events request. We want to give a shout out to a friend of the show, Tiffany Terrell, who wanted you guys to know that there is an event coming up on May 14th from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. It's called Ladies and Gentlemen's Lifestyle Tea Party. So you come out and enjoy a day filled with embracing yourself, learning sexy habits, and to come out and enjoy products that will enhance a healthier you. Men and women are both welcome to attend. Please RSVP. Call 404-957-8946 and ask for Tiffany Terrell. But to get into some things for this weekend, there's an art fair in Peachtree Corners. You know, normally don't go to art fairs like that, but you guys should. They're pretty cool. Mm-hmm. It's Westland's Art Market, and it has 95 artists, entertainment, and a children's market that's going to be at Peachtree Corner.
Cool.
I believe that that's free. And at Emney Park, there's the Emney Park Springs Festival, which features tours of homes, street parades, artist markets, live music, food vendors, kids' activities, and that's going to be from Saturday to Sunday, and that is absolutely free. And if you need more events to check out, go to events12.com. All right, guys, it's time to wrap up the show. Thank you so much for coming on and being a fantastic guest.
Thank you very much for having me once again. I enjoyed it, and I enjoyed the new location.
Yes.
I'm excited.
And we have to have you back on even after you win Superior Court Judge because
definitely.
We know you will.
Definitely. Thank you. I'll be glad to be back.
Yeah. Can you tell everybody one more time where they can find out more information?
Yes. Social media, Judge Knights, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Judge, K-N-I-G-H-T-S, website, Knights2016.com, K-N-I-G-H-T-S 2016. May 2nd, early voting. Be sure to vote. And it's nonpartisan. If you don't vote in May, you can't vote in November. Your vote counts. Superior Court Judge Stephen Knight, your most qualified candidate for Superior Court Judge.
Awesome. Miss BJ.
Yes.
Hashtag of the week.
Hashtag of the week is, are y'all finished or are y'all done?
Well, to answer your question, yes, we are finished and yes, we are done. Guys, you're listening to The Real with Rachel D. And thank you so much for joining us here every Friday. We want to leave you with another party song for our dearly departed, dearly beloved Prince, 1999. And we'll catch y'all next week.